Well, you don't need to be drinking that beer, though. Because it's good for
Oh, When it was at the man's talking about cheating and sleeping and fucking, like, that's some real shit.
The most successful time in my life.
When Kirk started crying.
And I asked him, what?
I probably didn't get depressed.
And how you like, dude?
Frustrated with everything.
That shit gets you.
Just thinking about that.
It's frustrating. You do all you can for your family.
Yeah.
It's like,
they ungrateful ass.
Yeah.
You're too happy with them. They're unhappy. I'd rather not too depressed. Okay, so let's get it that way. If you say you're really not in depression, then we fight that much harder for happiness.
Absolutely. We have to have the mindset that it's important.
Correct. And that's what I'm saying.
And if you already, right, if you already under the mindset that happiness isn't that important, you don't fight that hard for happiness.
Someone says, are you happy? Well, yeah. I mean, I'm not in 40. I'm content. I'm satisfied.
I'd rather
really not. I'm tired. So I don't know what happiness means in a marriage or a life. What's easy is to not get your hopes up high. So I can say, I can just stay right here and not have to eventually get my hopes up high. You know what I'm saying? But I didn't know that trying to balance that zero is risking depression.
And we say all that, and now I have a question with your wife.
Thank you. is to answer these questions in a way that helps them know that you have to make your tasks and help conversations and touch. You sit down, everyone can write down topics, questions, concerns. I imagine they're going to have a lot of feelings getting old and out.
Then you just ain't scared to be looking around. Yeah, show y'all how much she might put in here. What's wrong with it? He cutting it all cheesy. It's gonna be hella cheesy.
Yeah.
Okay, noodles. Gonna sauce it, and you want to make sure you spread it out evenly so you won't have those clumps and things in your lasagna. What I like to do is add a little sugar.
You know, I hate sugar in any kind of pasta. That's a no-no.
It's just to make it sound good. You know how they be doing on TV. Now, what I like to do is add a little sugar.
You want
to
cut the acid, add some sugar. I don't like sugar. I hate sweet pasta.
Baby hates sweet pasta.
Give me all my acid.
Not my favorite either. I don't gotta eat no sweet pasta. And this is also a cure for COVID.
She's the cure for COVID.
Okay, baby, you gotta save some for the top. So you want to have it nice and thick. You don't want to play with it.
What did she use?
So on this layer, I'm going to add a little pepper jack cheese.
No.
On my side.
Okay.
I'm going to add a little pepper jack cheese. She's going to eat it.
No, I'm not. Babe, don't put it on the whole thing.
Nice and cheesy. We have the mixed cheese in here, so it's a little bit of everything. She's gonna scrape it till she gets the last little bit out. And then I'll go ahead and smooth it over with the done. Then with that, you guys, you see how it's getting a little full. See how this side is a little higher than that side because it was two noodles folded on this side. We should have evened them out a little bit more, but we'll take care of that. And here we're gonna add the rest of the noodles. And this one, it's a little curved. We'll just fold it on this side and we can probably drag a little curve. Even it out. I like your curve. Baby got a curved finger, y'all. Really bad. And I'm gonna get that. I'm gonna try to even it out.
Now just put the rest of the sauce.
Now we're gonna put the last layer of the sauce, which won't be as thick as that. We'll try to make it work. I did kind of sauce the other part kind of heavy.
Get all of that, all of that.
And I'm kind of just smooth it over, smooth.
Push it in the corner, the noodles down in the corner.
Smooth it over. And once baby get out my ear telling me how to.
She's a sous chef, I am the head chef.
I'm gonna get the rest of it out. Just give me a second. While this is baking, I'm gonna take a quick shower.
How long does it have to bake?
Good 30 minutes.
It's usually about 45 to 50.
It depends on who's fixing it. Okay, so I'm gonna rinse this out and let Renata put the cheese on. We like to clean as we cook.
Definitely.
And you want to put some of this cheese on your side for real? I want to try to
make it. Look at the spoon.
I want to put two cubes on there. Try it out. Just cheese, you guys. Clean up a little bit.
Where do you want your cubes at, baby?
Put two cubes at a corner.
You want a corner slice.
Oh, Okay. Did you want some to put this on top of this all the cheese we want? It's good? Huh, baby? Put some more cheese right there for this one. All right, voila. Let's see the finished product. Where my spoon? She keep taking my spoon. Okay, finished product. And now what we're gonna do is put some,
cover it with oil.
Want the steam to kind of cook it for you. Oven at 400 degrees. Put everything now that everything's clean, we're going to jump in the shower and relax and await for dinner.
Sticky, all the cheese. Coming out, strike it back on the back. From the side, back. Like this. Just get the cheese back. like in the cartoon when it cheese be out.
Oh, shit.
Cheesy.
Okay. No, I just eat some of them cheese stick things. I'm really not even hungry. Yay! Can I do it, baby?
Our first lasagna.
Yay! Together. We made it together. Woohoo! And this has been Real Life with
the Rhodes.
All right, so now we have finished making our wonderful lasagna.
Lasagna.
And we're going to eat. I'm going to hop in the shower and call it a night because it is now almost, what, 10, 11 o'clock? 10 o'clock.
Too late to be eating.
I don't have to go to work. She got to go to work in the morning. Mm-hmm, and mm-hmm. This has been
Cooking with the Rhodes.
Woo! All right, so be sure you guys subscribe, like, share, and hit that notification bell.
Click.
And stay tuned for the rest of our Vlogtober, Real Life with the Rhodes. Peace out. See you next time.